Now, for families living in poverty, Christmas can be a really hard time of year. And unfortunately, after the last couple of years of COVID, many parents are under even greater financial stress.
But the Smith family's annual Christmas appeal and toy drive aims to make sure as many kids as possible from disadvantaged families wake up on Christmas morning to gifts under their tree.
And joining us now is the Smith family's CEO, Doug Taylor, good mate of mine. Nice to see you, Doug. Thank you so much for being with us. Now, this is something that's a bit different for the Smith family because we know the Smith family is focused on breaking the poverty cycle through education. But a couple of days out from Christmas, how many donations have you got and what kind of gifts are you encouraging people to give?
Yeah, thanks, Sarah. G'day, Ange, and g'day to your viewers and happy Christmas to you all. And it's a really busy time of year for us at the Smith family. We've supported nearly 30,000 families with our toy and book appeal, which makes a big difference on Christmas Day. But we're also focused on our Christmas campaign. So we've got a goal to raise $5.6 million for our learning and mentoring programs. We're about $2 million short at the moment. Clearly, cost of living is impacting people's ability to make a contribution. But as you've just said, the need is significant with the increase in cost of living at the moment, having a big impact on a lot of families in need right across the Australian community where a lot of those families have to make really impossible decisions between what they use their limited funds on. Do they put money, petrol into the car? Do they, buy food or go pay rent? So it's a really difficult time.
Yeah, it certainly is. The Smith family has been helping families in need for a really long time, 100 years this year, Doug. Can you tell us the story about how the Smith family came to be? Who is the Smith family?
Yeah, it's a great story. So it started with five businessmen were travelling back from Western New South Wales, having a meal in a pub in Parramatta. We're wondering what Christmas looks like for families in need. That led them to take a whole bunch of presents to an orphanage. And when the matron of that orphanage said, "Who should I thank?" one of them said, "Thank Mr. Smith," and the others said, "Well, we're all Mr. Smiths," because they wanted to be anonymous in giving at the time. And so the Smith family has grown from there. And, you know, as we discussed in the past, Sarah, they had this wonderful name early on called the Joy Spreaders because they did so much at Christmas, which is a wonderful quaint name when you think about it. But but the Smith family's been there for the Australian community through wars and through difficult times and depressions and the like, and still providing our wonderful programs today and very much education-focused today.
Now, Doug, Sarah here is an ambassador for the Smith family, and we believe you've got something you'd like to say to her on her last show.
Oh,
I absolutely do. Thanks, Ange. So, look, Sarah's been a wonderful supporter of the Smith family for about 8 years now, and I have to say that support has been in front of the camera and behind the scenes. Sarah and Studio 10 have just been wonderful in promoting the work of the Smith family and our education program. So many Australian young people can benefit from our program, so it's made an enormous difference for us. But equally behind the scenes, Sarah's been at our learning clubs, reading to some of our students, making an enormous difference. She comes to our events and helps promote our work. In fact, was just recently at an event in Sydney and hosted a panel session with some of our students and just had such an enormous impact on those young people. And, in fact, everyone there, Sarah just connects so deeply with our young people. It's quite significant. And, you know, in fact, one of our young people said afterwards, a couple of weeks after, that she was still thinking about the conversations she had with you, Sarah, such that it's had such an impact on her and her mum. And I've got to say, whenever we have these events, everyone flocks to Sarah. They want to spend time with her. They just absolutely love her. And you know, what I think we'd say is that, you know, you're so thoughtful and caring and just, you know, engage deeply with this, with the work that we do with our young people and the difference we're making in setting up them for making the most of their education and building a great future. So Thanks so much, Sarah, and to everyone at Studio 10. We really do appreciate your support.
Oh, Doug, what beautiful words. Thank you so much. And if you'd like to spread some Christmas cheer, make sure you donate to the Smith family. The toy drive, of course, or you can sponsor a child, which is how you kind of really enact long-term practical change. You can head to thesmithfamily.com.au. Doug, thanks so much for your time, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you. All the best.